Hi guys, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the previous video, we have seen how a third-party app like a WhatsApp or a Skype can access the content from the another application through the content resolver and then pass through the data using a cursor. It was more of a theoretical concept that we have gone through in the previous video. In this video, we will get into more specifics. The content provider basically mimics table containing the columns and rows of a database. So let us have a look at a typical SQL statement that you write to query a SQLite database. You usually start with select and then the columns that you want to query from the table from where you want to query the data. Then typically you write selection clause, which is where column equals to some value, and then if at all you want to order it by any one particular column or columns. Now we need to mimic exactly this using the query method of the content resolver. So when you invoke the get content resolver, you get a content resolver object, and then to the content resolver object you invoke query method, which is equivalent to a select SQL statement. The very first argument that query method takes is a content URI. All the content providers that are defined will be having this particular constant defined, which is a public static constant using which you can come to know the table that you want to query from the content provider. In Android, most of the content providers are defined under android.provider package. So you can just go through the Android documentation to access any one particular content provider. Now the next argument after providing the content URI is the projection. Projection is nothing but the number of columns or a particular set of columns that you want to query from the table. And typically it is nothing but a string array representing the names of the columns that you want to query from the content provider. The next parameter is the selection clause. Selection clause is equivalent to a where clause that you put in a SQL statement. For example, where column 1 equals to some value. And it is a string data type. Then the last one is sort order, which is basically the order in which you want the query to be sorted. You usually provide the column names. And then you have another argument, which is M selection arguments. If you recall, the M selection clause basically contains column and value, giving filter kind of effect. When you use this, you can pass a null as the value in case of M selection arguments. But sometimes, as a part of convenience, you want to give the values at the runtime. In that case, M selection clause typically looks like column 1 equals to question mark and column 2 equals to question mark and so on. The question mark will be replaced by some of the values against which you want the comparison to happen. So there is no exact equivalent of this in a typical SQL statement. And after this, you basically get a cursor. Cursor is nothing but a reference which you want to iterate over a table containing multiple number of rows. And the way we do it is always check whether cursor is not equal to null and number of rows that are there in the cursor is greater than zero. Then only you proceed further to avoid any kind of runtime exceptions. Then you write a while statement to iterate over the rows of the table. The move to next method basically ensures that you move to the next row in the returned table from the content provider. Enough of theory, let's get into a demo. I have created an application containing an activity. The main activity contains code to query the content provider. You can observe that in the manifest file, I have written the uses permission tag where I am getting the permission to read the contacts. Now going back to the main activity at line number 36, I have invoked the get content resolver, which initializes the content resolver, and then I basically use content resolver dot query. The first argument is contact contracts dot contacts, then the content URI, which is basically like telling which table I want to query, and then I am passing column projection, which is nothing but a array of strings containing some column names that returns me a cursor. And then at line number 43, I am checking if the cursor is not equal to null and the count is greater than zero. Then only I am iterating the cursor and I am using a string builder. Using a string builder is much more efficient than a string to construct the final output. After that, I am just setting queried value to the text view. And in case if this condition fails, I am just setting the message as no contacts in the device. So let me run this code. As of now, there are no contacts in the application. So as you can see, it displays the same, no contacts on the device. And now let me go back and create few contacts here. So now I have around 4 names in my contact list. So I should be able to see those 4 contacts when my application gets launched. As you can see, those are the 4 names that are there in my contact list. Now, clause that I want to put is, if the display name primary is equal to Anil, then only the query should succeed. So let me just use this string value and place it here. And let me rerun the code. Now you will observe that it will return only one row value because the where clause only succeeds for one row. And if you want to use a question mark, then you have to pass the selection arguments. That is the third parameter. Wherever there is a question mark, it will be replaced with the corresponding index from the string array. So right now I have only one question mark. So only one element in the array is sufficient. So let me rerun this. As you can see, the comparison display primary key question mark got replaced by Anil and I got the response as a row containing Anil. I can just change it to something else and it should just work fine. As you can see, there is no name with spelling AJY. Instead of this, if I just correct the spell, it should give me the correct value. And last but not the least is basically the sort order. You can just give the name of the column along which the sort order needs to be decided. I have used a variable here, something called as display name primary. I will give that and I will remove the selection arguments so that I want to basically get the complete result of the query. So let me run this. You can see that they are there in the sorted order. If I remove it and then run, the order is different. So basically the sort order, the last argument decides the sorting of the query result. As you can observe, this particular iteration over the data is happening in the main thread of the application. As the number of names are very small here, so that should not be a very major issue. But in case the data is very huge, iterating over the huge set of data on a main thread will definitely induce a possible ANR, that is application not responding situation. So ideally you should do it in a separate thread or a non-UI thread. Is there a other possibility? That is where the concept of loader comes into picture. We shall see that in the next video. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.